I've always been a nurturer. I'm always the one that takes care of everybody. My mom and dad, they got married quite young. I love them to death. They just weren't meant to be together. It was very hard for me to go decide who I wanted to live with because I love them so dearly and I felt like as if I would hurt either of them. I'm grateful for the life that my parents were able to give me, even though they were going through their own emotions and their own strife and sorrow. Even though my family was divided due to divorce, we were never divided through love. My sister and I are 10 years apart, and that was the best gift they ever gave me because I no longer was alone. She basically slept in the same bed with me from 16 months until I moved out when she was around 10, 11 years old, literally every night. She was my blessing, so I never wanted anything to ever happen to her or for her to ever see of my parents in their worst states that I had seen. I was in grade 9, and my sister was going to daycare. So what I would do was I'd carry two bags to high school. I'd have one bag with my clothes and my sister's clothes and my school bag. But I would never tell anybody what was going on. Most teenagers would say, oh, that's a burden to take care of your sibling, because my mom worked two jobs and my dad was living in the West End. But I actually loved it because my sister was my blessing, because she was now showed me that I'm not alone anymore. Even though I didn't do any school activities because I picked her up after daycare or I didn't really hang out, she kept me out of trouble because I had her all the time, to the point where people used to think that she was my daughter. On the outside, everybody at school saw me as the funny, quirky, I got it all together girl, like Camille, ha ha ha, Camille have problems? Yeah, right. But on the inside, this is back in the 90s when mental health wasn't a thing. I had massive anxiety, depression. I lost my period at one point. I had like the first one, my anorexia, like hair, like that white hair on my hand, on my arms. I think I got my period like twice in high school, in the entire high school. But I was very good at masking my inner self because I always felt like I didn't want to be a burden. I would laugh and play and everything in front of everybody's face, and then I'd go home and I'd shut the door and I would sleep. I was put on Paxil at 15. I got like things stuck to my head to check my serotonin. I was always the best friend. I was the confidant. You know, I was my sister's keeper. I'd help out when my mom was working. You know, I didn't want to make my dad sad, so I would just, you know, always be happy around him. But inside, I was like literally dying. I didn't know how to express myself, and nor did I want to, because I didn't want to be looked at as not having it together. You know, it was embarrassing. I feel guilty because, you know, I've never had that trauma of physical or mental abuse. So then I get mad at myself, say, how dare I feel this way? My husband is an amazing gentleman, but he is a man that lives through survival. His form of love sometimes is in the form of survival, as opposed to just noticing me. As I grow and as I glow in my own greatness, you know, he appreciates it and supports me, but doesn't understand it. My personal growth and personal development is making me a better woman, a better mother, and I want to be an even better wife.
I need to give myself permission to and know that the only person I'm really truly battling is myself. I've had the blessing of having even the worst person turn around and say thank you because of the energy that I have. So I need to honor my own energy and really know that I am my own superhero. I actually love helping and I love inspiring people. I love motivating. I want everybody to see the greatness that I've always felt about myself in them. I want to leave a legacy that will last far beyond my death. Legacy that says that, you know what? Camille did it because she loved me.